excellence, sophistication, sensuality. Long ago, Alexander Zulin and Maya Usova captured the hearts of skating fans everywhere. Tonight, they hope to capture their first world championship.
The 1993 World Figure Skating Championship
was in this very building in 1962. Canada enjoyed its greatest ever success at the World Figure Skating Championships, winning a total of 4 medals, 2 gold, 1 silver, and a bronze. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our continuing coverage, primetime coverage of the 1993 World Championships. 31 years later, in this same building, Canada has a realistic shot at equaling that total. Already 2 gold, Kurt Browning last night, of course, Brasseur and Eisler on Wednesday, 1 silver in that gutty performance as Elvis Stoiko staged a tremendous comeback here last evening. Now tonight, the women's technical program, experts are saying Josie Schwedard and Karen Preston have an outside shot at a bronze medal. Also tonight, the dance finals, and a bonus. We will continue a tradition we started in Paris in 1989. I will talk with Kurt Browning, and he will take you, the viewer, through last night's World Championship program. A big night here in Prague as we check in with CBC's Chris Cuthbert. Chris?
Thanks, Brian. Good evening, everybody. Two contrasting events for you tonight. Later, it will be the free dance. Maya Usova and Alexander Zulin are the heavy favorites to lead a Russian sweep of that event. But first, the women's technical program. There are no heavy favorites and challengers from all over the world. And with their thoughts on that, here are Barb Underhill and Paul Martini.
Well, Chris, there certainly isn't a Christy Yamaguchi favorite in the field here. However, there are many contenders, including our very own Josie Schwedard. Now, she needs a very strong technical program to remain in the running, but if she can put that together with a very strong long program like she had at the Canadians, I think we'll see her on the medal podium. Canada's Karen Preston has been very strong all week in practice, and she has the luck of the draw. She skates second last in the field, and with a good skate, she could be in a good position going into the long as well. But Paul, there are many youngsters to deal with out here as well.
Well, Barb, Oksana Bayula, Tanya Shevchenko, and Liu Chen are all 16 or younger, and Liu Chen is the current bronze medalist. As this field is wide open, all of these women have to be considered contenders, as well as the European champion, Saria Bonnelly. But if any of these women have pressure to deal with, it's the American Nancy Kerrigan. 2 years ago in Munich, the American swept the podium. But this year, Kerrigan is going to have to really perform to retain her silver medal. But let's anticipate no more and go to the ice for the women's technical program.
Paul, Saria Bonnelly.
There are 8 of them, and it's do or die.
Of the World Championships and try to block out that terrible start.
It all depends on how all the other ladies came.
That's true. It has been epidemic at times, hasn't it?
It's been known to happen.
In a row, Lisa has finished second in the World Junior Championships. So a meteoric rise this year from number two in the World Juniors to competing in the World Seniors as the U.S. number two.
A lot of responsibility for a young lady.
In her world debut, Lisa Irvin, perhaps the weight of skating for Carol Heiss and for her teammate Tanya Kwiatkowski, a little too heavy.
Well, the rest of the program was great, but once you miss the combination, you're pretty much out. You never want to depend on others' mistakes for your placing. And here's her triple loop. Watch her right side. Watch it drop right there. That's where it went.
Marks for the required elements, and there's nothing uglier than, in any language, the sound 4 point something.
Well, unlike the long program, the technical program does require specific deductions for missed elements.
Will the artistic impression be, or the performance be, any better?
Yeah, of course, because the performance was good. She was a little flat after her disappointment, but the performance was good.
She didn't want to hear any excuses. She just didn't do it. Lisa Irvin.
True competitor.
Yeah, I like her moxie. Tanya Sevchenko. She's only 15 years old. Dusseldorf, Germany.
In the technical program, there are 8 elements. 3 jumps, 3 spins. Footwork in a spiral sequence. The hardest are the double axel and the jump combination. She opens with the double axel.
Thank you.
we talked about a whole new world for the ladies in 93. There's a classic example. Not many of us knew anything about Tanya Shevchenko arriving in Prague, but remember that face and that name. There's a star of the future.
The combination is always the most difficult element in the technical program. Here's the triple loop, double toe loop. The jumps are optional. This one's a little easier than the ones we'll see later, but it was very well done.
And now the marks for Tanya Shevchenko, first for the required elements, and very solid from 5-2 through 5-5 from the Italian judge. The tour beyond her 15 years.
And there's nothing like your first world championship.
I think of the face of Coach Meyer. He knows he has something special.
Well, her performance was charming and clean, although her skating is a little weaker than the rest of the ladies will be seeing.
And now for presentation, and those marks confirm the positive world debut of young Shevchenko from Dusseldorf, Germany.
You know, the story of the World Championships has been comebacks from disappointing 92 seasons for Brasseur and Eisler and for Kurt Browning. Well, it was a disappointing 92 campaign for Saria Bonnelly, but she wants to tell everybody that she's back, and the European champion of the last 3 years is certainly one of the skaters to beat here.
Well, last year we were sort of excited for Saria going into the Olympics and the World Championships because she'd won the Europeans and then, you know, struggled at the Olympics and then placed 11th at the World Championships. So here, I'm sure, after again winning the Europeans, she'd like to get everything back on track. Double flip with a variation with her hands over her head, showing a good degree of control. But what I noticed most in Saria's performance here was a degree of relaxation. I felt like she was out there skating for the gold in the figure skating competition in the ladies event, as opposed to skating for gold for her country, which was the pressure she was under at the Olympics. A much more relaxed performance.
Here's a look at the triple lutz. Look at that, just a perfect jump straight up into the double toe loop. She's also had a coaching change. She is now with Alan Gilletti, and I think part of the problem last year was her coaching situation. She just didn't seem happy. She seems a much more comfortable, happier skater out there this year.
Well, she did admit that the pressure last year going into the Olympics was overwhelming. We see some French fans here, but last year they expected a medal, and when she finished fifth, it was crushing. She went on to Oakland and was 11th, so that's a good sign that she just caved in under all that pressure and expectation. This year, when we talked to her, she said she really hadn't been the focus of attention at all in the French media. She will be after that skate, and look at these marks, technical marks, 5-6s from Bulgaria and China, but they go up from there. 5-8 from Belgium. There is a 5-5 on the board. Another 5-8 from Poland. Italy 5-8. So, well, strong set of technical marks.
Well, as Elvis Stoiko has been criticized, Saria has been criticized the same way. Excellent technician, questionable in the artistic impression half of the mark. We'll have to see what happens here. There they are.
The artistic marks go down on most of the cards. But nevertheless, the ordinals are straight across. 9 first-place ordinals for Saria Bottom. Canadian champion Jose Chouinard is on deck. We'll be back with the Canadian Champions Technical Program after this. Well, it's interesting that they try to accentuate the smile because she can light up the skating rink. Here she is, the Canadian champion for the second time in 3 years. And the big question, can she keep this Canadian wave going after Browning and Stoiko last night? A lot of people up here were saying now it's Jose's turn.
Well, it's really going to be up to the jumps in this program. Jose is such a natural jumper, a very easy jumper, but when she gets out here in competition, she gets excited and her legs get stiff. So if she can keep that under control, I really think she has a good shot out here today.
Demonstration of control there, and that double flip with her hand over her head, and an outstanding performance for Jose Chouinard.
Well, this is going to be very interesting because, like Saria Bottom, she did the triple lutz double toe combination as well. So jump for jump, technically they're equal. It'll be interesting to see where the judges place them, though.
Well, in my card, there's no doubt Jose is going to beat Saria Bottom in the artistic impression mark.
Look at this combination. It's just technically perfect. Straight up into the second jump.
She just ran off the ice to hug Joanne Barbeau, her coach. What she wanted to do was be in a position after the short program, and she should be.
Hello, Maison. J'ai pensé à toi, Vicky.
It hasn't been easy all year, though. This is a skater that went to Oshawa for the divisionals and had a nightmare. She had boot problems this year, had trouble landing jumps, went back to the old boots just a week or so before the national championships, and it all came together.
No, I remember the feedback from that divisionals, and it was, what has happened to Jose Chouinard? And what has happened is she went home and pulled it all together, and here she is.
Technical marks, 5, 5, 6s, and 7s. The high mark there from Denmark at 5.7. Jose was 6th in Munich in 1991, 5th at last year's World Championships in Oakland. Now they go up a bit, but just one first place ordinal, that from Denmark. The other eight judges have her seated behind Bodlink, but Chouinard is second behind the European champion. Nancy Kerrigan of the United States won bronze in a U.S. sweep in Munich in 1991. She was the silver medalist last year in Oakland. Yet there's a lot of pressure on her here because she is the last American hope for a medal. And I think she's felt that pressure.
It'll be interesting to see what combination she attempts out here, because on the warm-up, she practiced two of them. One, a double-toe, triple-toe, which is a little bit easier, and the other, the Lutz combination, which actually it looks like she's going into right now.
We'll be back with the marks for Nancy Kerrigan after this. To Brock, she said she was a little nervous, but it didn't look like it.
No, she didn't look nervous at all.
The British judge got too sure at 5.4, but the other judges certainly liked it. 5.8 and a 5.9 for the Belgian judge.
Fleming.
From Stoneham, Massachusetts. Now the presentation marks.
Really?
7 first-place ordinals, 2 third-place ordinals. The British judge and the judge from Poland have her seated third as she assesses the marks with Coach Debbie Scott-Bolt. But Nancy Kerrigan certainly has got the Americans back in the medal picture. Kerrigan now the leader, Bonnelly second, and Chouinard is in third place. Here's the 16-year-old sensation that dazzled us in Helsinki at the European Championship from Ukraine, Oksana Baiul, the silver medalist there. You'll remember her original program there. She went into the boards, the lace came loose, she had to reskate. Always something different with her. Today in the warm-up, she came out a minute after her fellow competitors. We weren't sure if she was going to show up.
The other thing is, once they announce her name, she likes to stand by the boards, and she isn't ready until she tells them that she's ready. She's really in control out there. Combination as well. This is the combination that she went into the boards on at the European Championship. I just can't believe this ladies event. It's just unreal. They're just knocking off these combinations.
Body language like nobody else out there. She can be powerful one moment, flirtatious the next, sensual the next. She just has a command of the audience like no other woman in this event.
Well, she reminds me of a Russian ice dancer, the way she moves her body, but she's also got the jumps as well.
Well, the judges in the stands, I think, are giving her the highest mark so far. Clearly, the most reaction for Oksana Baiul of Ukraine. She is dazzling.
As you mentioned, Barb, the consistency with which these women are knocking off these triple lutz double toe combinations indicates that perhaps to set yourself apart from the crowd, the women are going to have to start entertaining the thought of doing a triple axel combination, because that doesn't seem to be enough to set you above the rest of the crowd technically.
And like the great athletes, they have tremendous confidence. After Europeans, her first major international, she wins the silver and says, I'm going to win at Worlds. And she might. Galina Zmeskaya, coach of Viktor Petrenko as well,
Well, it's interesting that I was talking to Galina, and she said that Victor actually finances Oksana's skating. He buys her skates, he buys her costumes, he pays for the ice time. There's not a lot of money to go around in that camp.
Didn't see Galina in Helsinki. Valentin Nikolaev on the right of the screen was supervising her in her silver medal performance at the European Championships. The only problem that they've had with her is keeping her away from the chocolate bars this week. Technical marks, 5-6 from Poland and China, 5-7s and 8s. These marks may not be as high as Nancy Kerrigan's.
Well, I don't really understand this. I thought clearly she was by far the best.
Well, I felt she carried 6 speeds through the whole performance. I did notice on one of her layback spins, she traveled a little bit, but it was a minor detail.
Now presentation marks. There's a 5-6 from China, but 5-9s from Italy and Japan, Czech Republic and Bulgaria. 2 first-place marks from Japan and Britain. The rest are second-place ordinals, and she is in second behind Kerrigan. Jose Schwinard now fourth, and she's standing by with Brian.
All right, thank you, Chris. Jose Schwinard. Gene Semph was talking about the 8 required elements and how tough the double axel is. You nailed it. What were your thoughts going into that axel?
Well, I knew that I had to do it, smaller, because when I tried to do it bigger, a nice one, I tried too hard and I just lose my control. But I tried to do a smaller one, but I'm with a nice landing. So.
Now, in addition to the double axel, you had a great triple-double combination. Tell us about that.
Well, I felt good. I felt relaxed going into it, and I guess that's all I missed during the week. So that's why it wasn't perfect. And today I felt so relaxed. I knew if I didn't get it the whole week, I had to do it today. So I was pretty relaxed going into it.
Listen, she talks about being relaxed. I saw her in a restaurant about 4 hours ago in the hotel. I've never seen you so relaxed. What have you done to get this way?
I don't know. I guess I've worked so hard the whole year, and I guess it had to be there. It had to be there. That's all I said. And I've been working and trying so hard. I said it doesn't work. So let's go out there and enjoy yourself with the crowd and the people.
You have the brightest outfit. Is there a story with this outfit?
Well, I was looking for it almost a year, and I was just hoping that anybody would miss me on the ice.
Well, they won't miss you on the ice, outfit or not, the way you skated tonight. Congratulations. Good position for a medal tomorrow. Jose Schwinard, let's go back to Chris Guthrie.
Thank you, Brian. Jose fourth right now in a technical event where just about every skater has been at their best. And here is one of the best. Last year's bronze medalist at the World Championships in Oakland, Liu Chen of China.
Well, you know, earlier this week in the qualify round, Liu Chen came out and skated an absolutely clean performance. And I have to wonder if she didn't already put down her best performance of the week.
Well, we've seen a number of them so far, and here comes her attempt at the triple Lutz combination.
this panel right about now?
Well, I felt this performance was very well skated, but I didn't think it had the speed nor the attack that, say, Jose had or some of the other skaters currently sitting in the top three. But they say that to compete with the best, you have to train with the best. And Liu Chen has been doing some training in Blue Jay, California with Frank Carroll, and she will be going back there to continue training there. And she's certainly reaping the benefits of that experience.
Here's a look at her Lutz combination. Look at how close to the board she is already, but she gets good height and just pulls it around enough so that she doesn't hit those boards.
Back with the march for Liu Chen of China in a moment. Back in Prague with the technical marks for Liu Chen of China, 5-5, sixes and the 5-7 from the first judge, the Italian judge.
Well,
not as high as I thought they'd be.
Well, I think what it was, what you said, Paul, was that she just didn't have the attack like, say, Jose had. She was very cautious, especially on the double axel, I felt.
And this may be good news for Jose Chouinard as the presentation marks come up. 5-3 from Belgium, up to 5-7. She has a second place ordinal from the British judge. The rest are fourths and fifths, and Liu Chen, the bronze medalist a year ago, is in fifth place behind Jose Chouinard of Canada. Here's Canada's other hope and the last contender to skate, Karen Preston from the Toronto Cricket Club. And she's got a tough job ahead of her because the top eight so far have skated cleanly.
Karen has planned a triple flip combination, and on the difficulty scale, it's not as difficult as the Lutz combination, which has been performed by the top five competitors. Wow, there was no problem with that at all.
And she's smiling for Karen Preston. That's really something.
We don't often see her smile. That's great. Gorgeous layback spin.
Performance. And as you mentioned, Ron, here's that triple flip. Nice tight air position, hands tightly across the chest. Back up into the air for the double toe. She carries good flow through the jump, and look at her face when she hits that combination.
Great.
Thank you.
The 89 and 92 national champion of Canada. Silver medalist in Hamilton.
And like Kurt Browning, she made a coaching change this year. She also went to Louis Stong. Obviously, it's worked for her.
So, that was great.
Yeah.
Louis wife is
did you
proud
hear the, crowd
when
yeah,
she
that.
Got that double axel.
Well, he said to me last night, he said, Kurt doesn't make me nervous at all. It's Karen that makes me nervous.
Hi, guys. Hi, everyone back home. Kelly, Lance, Mike, Matt, Terry, everybody.
Hey, everybody. Granite Club people. Hi,
yeah.
Granite Club.
Granite Cricket. Love you guys all. Hey, Jess. Thanks, Mr. Sheard, for the dresses.
Has she missed anyone?
What was your best moment? You think,
oh, when I landed the jump.
You like that?
Yeah.
No, I liked a lot of the other stuff. The communication with the audience was wonderful. You just kind of let it go. It was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Looked like you're having fun.
The whole package was there, wasn't it?
Certainly was.
Now, what do the judges do with this? They thought they might have had the top five, but Karen Preston may have changed their mind here. Let's find out. Wow, technical marks not as high as I think we all expected. 5.2s, 3s, 5.6 from Bulgaria.
Well,
surprised?
No. Not as Barb mentioned. She did a triple flip, double toe combination. Not nearly as difficult as the Lutz. She did it well, and she did have a slightly tight landing on the double axel. More flow out of that jump would have been in her favor.
Now the presentation marks.
Good.
5.3s, 4s, and 5s. A fourth place ordinal from Bulgaria. Sixth place marks from Denmark and Belgium. 7s and 8s. And Karen Preston of Canada, who was 9th in Oakland last year, is 7th after the technical program. A women's technical event. Nancy Kerrigan of the United States, the leader. Oksana Baiul of Ukraine, 2nd. European champion. Saria Bonnelly of France is 3rd. Jose Chouinard is in medal position with the best technical skate she's had at the Worlds. Karen Preston, almost as impressive as we join Brian Williams.
All right, Chris, I first interviewed this lady at the Palais Omnisport at Paris back in 1989. Everyone is saying for the first time since then, they've seen Miss Personality.
Well, everyone's always joking, kidding that I look so serious on TV, and I've just always been saying it's because I'm so focused, but this program was designed to produce a Grace Kelly sort of effect, and I went out with the idea of going onto the ice with a secret that nobody else in the rink knew, so it worked.
Well, it worked indeed. Now, you go out, you nail the combinations, tremendous spins, no trouble with the tough part, yet tell me about squeaking out that landing on the axel.
Well, actually, right before Canadians, I had bursitis in my right hip, and that the movement right before it, the back spiral step double axel, I wasn't able to practice until I got here in Prague, so it was a little tense there for a while, but things worked out okay considering I didn't practice it for about 15 days.
And I imagine you're looking forward to tomorrow.
Very much so.
All right, good luck. Karen Preston, 2 Canadians in the top 10. Don't forget, the women's long program goes tomorrow night. Up next, I mentioned 1989 was the first time I interviewed Karen Preston. That was at the World Championships in Paris. It was also the first time that Kurt Browning won a World Championship. And speaking of Kurt Browning, when we continue from here in Prague, Browning will join me. And in a special treat for you viewers tonight, Browning will take us through his World Championship program from yesterday. Stay with us. And a silver medalist due after they win. This was the scene in this building, deserted, about 1:30 this morning. I was here doing some commentary. Browning and Stoiko clowning around at center ice. Needless to say, you weren't too uptight last night.
That we looked silly, but we was all done. We had the arena to ourselves, and we just wanted to go out and enjoy the moment, and that's what we're doing.
I talked to Karen Preston before the commercial about 89. It was your first World Championship in Paris. I wanted to do something different. You had a great suggestion. You said, why don't you let me take the folks through my championship program? We've done it 3 times. We did it with Lloyd and Isabel on Wednesday. So right now, I'm going to be quiet. You people at home in for a treat. Let's roll that videotape, and the world champion will take us through his program from last night. Kurt, go ahead. It's all yours.
I learned my lesson in Hamilton. I looked up into the audience just before my music started and saw Paul Martini and recognized his face and lost some concentration. So right now, believe it or not, I'm staring at a wall. trying not to acknowledge anybody. The first few steps of the program are always important to me. I just want to feel the ice and make sure that everything's real calm. And of course, nail the first jump. Nothing sounds better than that first applause.
It was loud, too.
There's certain moments in the program that are real special. Sandra Bezick has made a real masterpiece, and it's up to me to go out there in the right moment and make sure that I hit a few special moments. And that split jump at the end is really important to be right on time with the music. This is the first moment in the program where I can really start to relax. Check out who's sitting there. Oh, look, it's the judges. How you doing, guys? Hope you like my outfit. Unfortunately, this is where the concentration dissipates. You can see it. I'm thinking about Donald Jackson right now instead of what I'm doing. And I forgot how many feet I was supposed to land on.
Why were you thinking about Don, for those that weren't with us last night?
Donald Jackson, 31 years ago, made history and shocked the world with the first triple Lutz. And not my best jump, but something that's been going pretty good all week. And out of the blue, I started thinking about him at that moment. And, I mean, there's no rules about what we're thinking about out there, but why did I choose that moment? But it all came back together right here. Bringing that edge around as far as I can puts the spin in one end of the rink instead of right in the middle. And small things like that, when you remember that, gives you confidence as you're skating, because you're really thinking about every move. You're saying to yourself, I'm right over my skates, now I'm going to enjoy it. Rick Blaine just walked into his bar. There's a beautiful girl at the other end of the room. When I was in Hamilton skating this program, I looked up, and a judge that has been judging me for about 10 years was sitting right there. I gave her a big smile and a wink. And here, last night, I looked up, and Elizabeth Clark, the Canadian judge, was right there. Another smile, another wink. Things were going great. This is the highlight of the program for me, is this triple axel. I've had a bit of a break, a little bit of a breather. There's absolutely no excuse not to nail this. Hard elements are done, now it's going for the artistic one. Now that I'm seeing this program, it was actually quite comparable to Hamilton, but I like the new outfit better. Right now I'm thinking of Louis Stong, actually, because this is the part that worries him the most. All the difficult elements are done, and it's just a triple toe at the end of this solo, but I seem to, three times in a row, I've missed it, and this time I just didn't want to miss it. So I was so happy I almost missed this instead.
Lewis Stong, Kurt's coach, is standing off camera. I got to tell you, he's sweating right now. He's nervous watching it again a day later. Tell me about the importance of Elvis Stoiko. There's a very special relationship here between the two of you. He had a tough time on Wednesday. You went to him, talked to him, and you said in sort of a strange way that helped you.
Well, yeah, because I told Elvis that it was time for him to refocus. And, you know, I'm world team leader and Elvis's friend. And I know I'm his competitor, and, you know, it's tough competing against him. He's so consistent. But it was not the moment to be his competitor. It was the moment to be team leader and friend. And I also realized it was time for me to recalibrate my thinking. No longer was I competing against Elvis. It was sort of Ermanoff and Mark Mitchell, and I had to change the way I was thinking.
All right, thank you. You showed grace in defeat and class in Albertville, as you have in victory. That was not easy, so it was a tough year and a great reward.
So happy sitting here. Let's do it again sometime.
All right. Congratulations, world champion Kurt Browning. Lewis Stong, his coach, as I say, still got beads of sweat on the forehead. Congratulations to Elvis Stoiko. Stay with us. Lots more to come. The dance is up next when we continue from here at the Ice Palace in